blinking. We do it 15 to 20,000 times a day, without even thinking about it. But there's more than meets the eye when it comes to this seemingly simple action.
The main purpose of blinks, obviously, is to lubricate the eye. It brings oxygen to the eye, it brings nutrients, it keeps the film clear so we have a good image. At the same time, blinks also remove debris, so they help with really keeping the eye healthy.
However, studies show that we blink more often than needed for this maintenance. To understand why, let's look at how we perceive the world around us.
The way we explore a visual scene is through a combination of different types of eye movements. In the case of a stationary scene, what we do, we perform a rapid gaze shift, we call that a saccade, and then we fixate for a very short period of time, 300 milliseconds or so, on the new point, and then we move somewhere else. But if you look carefully, also in those moments in which we are fixating, we are continually moving our eyes. These small movements improve perceptions by increasing sensitivity to fine detail.
So while the object might be stationary in the world, but if we move our eye, then the object will move on the retina. So it creates some temporal changes, which will enhance the visual response of the neurons.
So what exactly happens when a blink momentarily blocks our view? To find out, University of Rochester researchers developed highly precise eye trackers. They measured people's visual perception as they performed voluntary blinks, reflexive blinks, and simulated blinks, where the stimulus was briefly removed from the visual field.
In all those cases, blinks increase sensitivity to the coarser structure of the scene. So we call those low spatial frequencies, smoothly varying surfaces, right? So whereas small movements enhance sensitivity to fine details, blink bring back sensitivity to the bigger structure of the scene.
While blinking temporarily disrupts our line of sight, it ultimately enhances visual perception of the environment as a whole.
One of the questions that emerges from this research, are we going to allocate blinks strategically according to the amount of information that I need at that time? Right? Are we going to use them in situations in which we do need to enhance sensitivity to the global structure? So that's going to be the next step.